Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create your very first project within ABBYY FlexiCapture. Before I get started, I will let you know that I'm using the distributed version of the product. There is also a standalone version of the product, and although things are very similar between the two, there might be slight name changes and some title changes to the applications. So let's get started. What I'm going to do is create a new project using File, New Project, and I'm just going to browse to our desktop and we'll call this our test project. The software is then going to create the project for us. And we're going to go to Project, Document Definitions, New. Today we're going to do a fixed form, which is a form that looks the same every time. In other words, the structure of the form does not change. And we'll hit Next. We're going to go ahead and load an image from a pre-existing file. You can use a physically scanned piece of paper if you want using the scanner option. But for today's demo, we'll use the Browse to an Image file and select a sample. We'll hit Next. We'll call this our direct deposit form. Before I hit next, I just want you to see the form here. I'm actually going to load it up on my screen. This is a very, very basic fixed form, and you can see this is pretty standard, and we're just going to capture a lot of this metadata here on this document to get us started. So I'm going to go ahead and hit next. This allows the software to automatically detect certain fields. For this demo, let's go ahead and leave those off. And we'll hit Finish. What the software will do at this point is take us into what's called the Document Definition Editor. And within this editor, we will see our sample. What I'm going to do is browse to our Elements options up here. You can see we can extract text, checkboxes, even a group of checkboxes, barcodes, pictures, or tables. What I'm going to do is extract the first name, last name, and employee ID for this given demo. And there's a couple of different ways to do this, but for this case, we'll hit Create Text. And you can see here, I'm going to just go ahead and draw within this box. Okay. I'll do that here within the last name. And I'll also do that here within employee ID. Okay. Now understand, every field has properties, including things as basic as giving it a name, data type, including is it text, is it a number, how the software recognizes the field, is it handprint versus text printed, how picky the software should be on its confidence level, so should the software treat a character with higher confidence or lower confidence. We can even set rules in what are called customs actions, and those are some advanced demos that we can do at a later time. So what I'm going to do is just go ahead and just set up each field with its name. This is our first name, the second field is our last name, and employee ID. At this point, you'd want to finish this form and continue adding the different styles that we have here, whether it be checkboxes or even tables if you're extracting them. And what we can do is perform a test. When we perform a test, it'll perform the test on this specific form that we've loaded within the Document Definition Editor. And you can see the software has extracted those fields with very high confidence. It did a very nice job. At this point, if that's all we were going to do, we would hit Save, and we would close our form. Once we get back to our list of document definitions, I will hit Publish. Publish will give this document definition the ability to be used for all processed documents moving forward. And for cases of a test, what we will do is we'll go to our View and Test Batches. We'll create a new batch, and we will load samples. Now that we have one created for the document definition, we will be able to process these. And you'll see here, as I select them, the software will then show us the employee ID, first name, and last name. And at this point, we have a successfully created document definition and project. From here, we will go to File and Upload. And we will then upload this to our server. At that point, we have a fully functioning project ready to be used in a production environment. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, would you do me a favor and click the like button, the subscribe button, and even click that notification bell so that you can be notified when we post new videos. Thank you.